present the award for favorite pop rock video single. Here are Julian Lennon and Amy Grant.
The nominees for favorite pop rock video single are Easy Lover, Philip Bailey with Phil Collins. The Power of Love, Huey Lewis and the News.
And the winner is... The Power of Love, Huey Lewis and the News.
We'd like to thank Tim Newman, who directed our video, and all the cast and crew, too numerous to mention, who were in it. We'd also like to thank you for settling a dispute within the group. You see, some of the guys felt that it was actually our records and our songs and the music itself which was the key to our success. But now we know the real reason. Thank you very much.
To present the favorite country female award, here are Paul Stanley, Eddie Rabbit, and in London, Billy Ocean.
Billy, you tell us the nominees, and Paul here will jump in for the big finish.
Okay. The nominees are for the country female award, so Crystal Gayle, Anne-Marie.
Who's the winner? Crystal Gayle.
Crystal Gayle. Crystal's not here tonight, so we'd like to just say congratulations. This is the second one she's got tonight. She's home in Nashville getting ready to have a baby. Well, I think tonight, baby, you had twins. Congratulations, Crystal. We'll accept
for you.
And now for a moment I've been waiting for. He was the host of the American Music Awards in 1981, and now it's time to welcome him back. Ladies and gentlemen, Teddy Pendergrass.
I just wanna have fun. I just wanna be with you, doing all the wonderful things, doing all things for two. I wish I could turn time back when you were mine. I wouldn't be so all alone. Oh no, I wouldn't be here without you. Girl, there's something I must confess. Smile on my face is only a shield, hiding the way I really feel. Walking in that night, holding conversation with only myself, just ain't no fun. I wanna love for two. If I had read the signs, the times when you were crying, oh, my foolish eyes wouldn't let me see that you needed me, yes. Baby, I'd walk a mile just to reconcile all our differences. I'm like dinner for two. Big for you. Oh, 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 well. Tired of being all alone. I need someone to call my own. Must confess, smile that's on my face is only a shield, hiding the way that I really feel. Walking in the night, holding conversation with only myself, just ain't no fun. I wanna love for two.
A very special moment on our show because it's time to present the annual American Music Award of Merit. We didn't have to look very far to find the presenter and a good friend of this show. He has just rushed over here from a recording session, and here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Lionel Richie.
Thank you very much. You know, originally I was supposed to be in London to present this award, but my album deadline has kept me here. In fact, the proof of the pudding is Motown would not let me leave the city limits until I finished this album. In fact, quiet as it's kept, Barry Gordy's out back waiting to drive me back to the studio. If you were the But I really couldn't miss being a part of this very special presentation. And when you find out who's being honored, you'll understand why. Among the recent recipients of this prestigious award of merit, Chuck Berry, Stevie Wonder, Kenny Rogers, Michael Jackson, Loretta Lynn, all outstanding American music personalities. Tonight, for the first time, this award goes out of the country to England. This story starts in Liverpool, where in the early 1960s, groups like this were playing American rock and roll.
Paul, this seemed like the perfect time to return a compliment to one of my favorite people that I love so much, that have been so beautiful in my life and so wonderful, that I met many years ago in Liverpool, the four of you, Paul, Ringo, George, and John, at this little ballroom. You remember that? I was playing and you all wanted to watch the king and the star. They don't want me to say king, but I am the king. And I love you. You were just getting started, and I'd like to thank you for enjoying my music and singing my songs.
But soon the Beatles were singing their own songs written by John Lennon and Paul McCartney. And the world started to listen. The Beatles' effect on their fans gave new meaning to my favorite word, outrageous.
When the 60s ended, so did the Beatles. After a little while, Paul became anxious to play for the people again. So he formed a group called Wings and hit the road.
Hi, Paul and all the gang. Congratulations on another award. I wanted to thank you for holding up your half of Bob Geldof at Live Aid. Heavy, very heavy character. What I like about you is that whatever you do, whether it's successful or failure, you've had a few, is that you have such fun, obviously. I've always respected that. Keep it up, and lots of love, and have a good time.
I've admired him as a friend. I've seen him with Linda and the children, and he's wonderful. But most of all, I've admired him as a creative musician. Looking back, we can see how we can easily look forward to more beautiful songs by Paul.
This year, Paul wrote the theme for Spies Like Us. But it's not the first film to contain a McCartney song.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been looking like a dog. Help,
I need somebody. Help, not just anybody.
Come on, come on, the mystery tour.
We all live in a yellow submarine. Yellow submarine, yellow submarine.
As you know, I've grown up listening to your music. I don't mean to put it date us all, but I think probably the worst thing for all of us is when you guys weren't together. Now I see you and Artie are still doing things off and on, and I guess it'll never be bridge over troubled waters, but... Oh! I'm sorry, Paul McCartney. I'm a serious guy. Congratulations. I do hope to work with you again and just to watch you work, because you are the best And I felt like a child when I came over to Abbey Road with Danny to do the Spies Like Us video.
Some of his songs with top American stars.
Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better.
Paul, we thought a good person to kind of sum things up would be one of the leaders of the new British invasion and an inspiration for the song Hey Jude, John's son, Julian Lennon.
Paul, I just wanted to say my father would be as happy as I am to see you honored in this way tonight. I just wanted to say congratulations, and here's to the future.
Before I pass the hat over, Paul, I'd like to say also that the first time we met in Los Angeles, I want to say that your personality and your hospitality was wonderful. And over the years, I think if I can consider myself a songwriter in any way, I can truly say that you have been a great, great inspiration in what I've been doing. And I love you, brother. And now, to present the award of merit here in London, England, Phil Collins. Phil.
Thank you, Lionel. Thank you. Thank you, Lionel. Thank you, everybody. Before I get on with business, I'd like to say what a personal pleasure this is for me to be here doing this for Mr. McCartney, because it doesn't seem like 20 years ago, over 20 years ago, when I was actually in A Hard Day's Night, and here I am now presenting this man with this award. I shall read it out. Because for over two decades he has been responsible for enormous changes in the sound and content of music, and because his songwriting, recordings and performances have had an unprecedented impact on the world, uniting generations in their enjoyment of music, the American Music Award of Merit is presented to Paul McCartney, January 27th, 1986.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you, Phil. Wonderful man. I'd like to thank a lot of people, but I'll thank just a few. First of all, I'd like to thank Lionel for dressing so wonderfully. Thank you for dressing up this evening. Fabulous, Lionel. Well, we know you came from the studio, but this is ridiculous. Anyway, I would seriously, though, like to thank some people without whom this wouldn't have been possible, and I'll put it down because it's heavy. I'd like to thank, first of all, my mum and dad, who would have been very proud to have been here. Thank you. I'd like to thank all the people who gave me this award, and the friends who've turned up in London and in Los Angeles tonight. There's too many of them to go into detail, but thank you very much for showing up. Wouldn't have been the same without you. I'll tell you what, these things are about the most nerve-wracking things, I think, that any of us do, you know, and I'm certainly no exception to this, but I'm going to carry on, just as if nothing had happened, right, Bob? You know what I mean? I would like to thank some other people without whom, as I say, this would not have been possible. All the people who give me the award, but especially the people who helped me get the award. And I'd like to thank very specially George, Ringo, and Julian's dad, John. Thank you very much. I love you. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you all. Peace on earth. Thank you.
Coming up next, who will win Top Female Vocalist Awards? Aretha Franklin, Whitney Houston, Madonna, Diana Ross, or Tina Turner?
you so much. That's wonderful. Thank you. Oh, no, it's all right. Thank you. Oh, to present the favorite pop rock female award from L.A., Jeffrey Osborne, and in London, Nick Feldman and Jack Hughes.
Oh. Okay, here's the plan. Jack and Nick, you guys tell us the nominees, and I'll announce the winner.
Okay. In the category of the favorite pop rock female artiste, the nominees are...
And the winner is... Tina Turner. Tina could not be with us tonight, so on behalf of Tina Turner, I'll accept this award for her. Thank you very much.
Presenting the award for favorite soul R&B single, female, here are the Golden Boys of Bandstand, Frankie Avalon, Fabian, and Bobby Rydell.
Thank you. Thank you. Before we get to the award, we've been asked to briefly describe the rules. Now, fellas, did you hear that? Briefly.
Yes, Daddy. The nominations are based on information compiled by Cashbox Magazine, one of the leading music entertainment trade publications for 43 years.
The independent survey firm of Herbert Altman Communications, Inc. sends the ballots to a representative sample of record buyers.
Then the ballots are tabulated by the national accounting firm of Pete Marwick and Mitchell, and the results are placed in a sealed envelope.
Envelopes.
Right. Okay, so right now let's find out the results of the favorite soul R&B female contemporary. The nominees are Aretha Franklin, Whitney Houston, Diana Ross,
and the winner is...
And the winner is...
Who is it?
Aretha Franklin!
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank the Voting Academy and all of you wonderful people who voted for me. I'd like to thank the musicians and the singers and everyone that helped me to make the Freeway album, and I'd like to accept it in memory of my dad, Reverend C.L. Franklin.
Next, Hank Williams Jr. with a giant hit song, Still to Come, a tribute to Rick Nelson.
I'm having fun, you see? To present the Favorite Soul R&B Album Award, here are Al Jarreau and Kim Carnes. Nominees for Favorite Soul R&B Album are Emergency, Coolin' Again,
The Night I Fell in Love, Luther Vandross, God Bless You, Luther. Winner, Emergency, Cool in the Gang. And they're here. And once again.
Thank you very much. I'd like to thank my mother and all of my family and friends back in Hackensack, New Jersey, and all the fans here and all the beautiful stars. We feel good. Thank God.
Thank you.
Our next star has done just about everything there is to do in country music. He sings, he writes, he plays a dozen instruments, wins awards, and now this. Tonight, he will take the theme song, another great country singer, George Burns, and give it a new meaning. Here, with Ain't Misbehavin', is Hank Williams, Jr. Nana Bear and the Bama Band. George! George, are you listening? Okay.
To talk with all by myself, no one to walk with, but I'm happy on a shelf. Ain't misbehaving, saving my love for you. Now I know for certain you're the one I love. I'm through with flirting, just you I'm dreaming of. Ain't misbehaving, saving my love for you. Like Jack Horner in the corner, don't go nowhere, why do I care? Your kisses are go. I'm home about 8, just me and my radio. Ain't misbehaving, saving my love for you. Now, Jerry. Jack Horner.
time for the Favorite Country Album Award. Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Martin Murphy and Stephen Stills.
The nominees for Favorite Country Album are...
Train they call the city of the
City of Knowledge, Willie Nelson.
At least you said it right.
Country Boy by Ricky Skaggs.
This is 40 Hour Week, Alabama.
And the winners are, let's see, is it the fastest picker in the world? No, it's Alabama.
Well, the only people I forgot to thank a while ago, it was the DJs that play our records so all the people know we have records. Without the fans, there's no point in recording. Thank you.
Phil Collins, Madonna, and Bruce Springsteen compete for the Top Album Award. And an all-star salute to Live Aid, coming next.
To present the award for Favorite Pop Rock Album, here in L.A. is Ray Parker Jr. and in London, John Pop.
All right, John, why don't you list the nominees and I'll hold the envelope.
Okay, Ray. And the nominees for Favorite Rock Pop Album are... Born in the USA, Bruce Springsteen.
Here we go. And the winner is Born in the USA, Bruce Springsteen. All right. Bruce is not here tonight, but God bless him and we accept this award for him. Thank you very much.
The award for Favorite Country Video by Mail. Ladies and gentlemen, Marlon Jackson and Al Gabar.
The nominees to Favorite Country Video by Mail are Lee Greenwood,
Ricky Skaggs, Hank Williams Jr., and the winner is Hank Williams Jr.
Well, this is the third one of these, the same video. So if there's any producers out there, I am available for movies. I also make audio too, though. I want to thank everybody. Mostly the people out there on the one-nighters that support us in the record shops and in the auditoriums around the country. Thank you, and God bless you.
To present the second American Music Award of Appreciation, here are No, here's Wham's George Michael.
In 1980, Bob Geldof, a member of the Boomtown Rats, told the world that he didn't like Mondays. In late 1984, Bob told the world that he doesn't like to see people starving, and he organized Band Aid made up of British rock stars.
Bob's success with his Band Aid recording provides the inspiration for We Are the World. And it was a memorable moment when he paid us a visit that night and told us about the conditions in Africa.
No one bring anybody down, but maybe it's the best way of making what you really feel, why you're really here tonight, come out through this song. So thanks a lot, everybody, and let's hope it works.
But Bob's crowning achievement was the most astounding pop event ever, Live Aid, a monumental, day-long global television event featuring performances by some of the top contemporary musical artists of the world, all for African famine relief.
Never intended on becoming a hero, but like or not, now you are one. But perhaps above all else, the most important thing you've done is you've shown us what one man can do when he sets his mind to it. You've made it hip to care. And now there's a whole new sense of hope here in the United States and around the world in general. People are into helping people again. A trend, I believe, thanks to you, will continue for a long time to come. So I want to thank you, Bob, for letting us all become a part of your dream.
Not only did you show the world the plight of the starving millions, but you did something about it. Thank you for letting me be part of it. Good luck.
Take a look at me now. Well, it's just an empty space. No one there.
Tried with our partner David Crosby to write songs that had a lot to do with what's going on in this crazy world.
And Bob, in 1985, you gave us a place and a reason to sing them again.
You certainly did.
And created a new sense of community in our interest.
I suppose by this time of the evening you've had to accept the fact that you have seriously and honestly changed the face of the 80s, which is a very important thing to do. It's up to the rest of us not just to praise you and laud you, but to carry on.
But this moment topped them all. And tonight deserves to be a great night for him. To present the award of appreciation in London, here is Roger Daltrey.
Thank you. Thank you, George. Thank you very much. Well, I'm sure that everyone will agree with me that the person most deserving
of the American Music Award of Appreciation in 1985 is really, there's only one person. Mr. Bob Geldof. His extraordinary energy and his powerful feelings for the less fortunate touched the heart of the music industry. It resulted in Band Aid. It was followed by the Live Aid concert, seen by worldwide audiences who responded with concern and generosity. For his inspiring leadership, the American Music Award of Appreciation is presented to Bob Geldof. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's a bit big to wear, but I'll have it scaled down for tomorrow. Talking about wearing things, nobody told me that tonight was a dress-up occasion, but I should have remembered from last year. You're probably sick of seeing me wearing the same jacket for the past year. But then again, unlike Phil Collins, I didn't get a part in Miami Vice and then steal the clothes. A lot of us, certainly everybody that's here tonight and over there in Los Angeles, will remember the part we played in it, but it's a minor part. And the main thing we did was to raise the issue. And when we raised the issue, we collected the money as a result of raising that issue, but greater still, we made a huge political constituency for change. And unless the politicians of the world recognize that constituency for change, where people are not prepared to sit down and watch another child die in their living rooms, then the people of Africa and the hungry people everywhere will go on crawling about the earth looking for a subsistence level, while we wallow really in the surplus of our imaginations. And so amongst the euphoria tonight, which I thank you for, the last year has been spent getting a lot of these awards. I'm very proud of this, but I'm ambivalent about it, because I got this because people were dying and because we did something for it. And that's a terrible thing to win an award for. Thank you.
Make successful comebacks, and some artists are like our next one, have never been away, not for a minute. Hit after hit has been coming in at us from her latest album, Who's Zooming Who. So let's go live to the Premier Center in Detroit for the one and only Aretha Franklin.
Calling. I hit my stride when the evening is falling.
Performance by Kool and the Gang, plus Philip Bailey, Prince, and Stevie Wonder compete for a top video award.
To present the award for favorite soul R&B video by mail, here are Jack Wagner and the Motels, Martha Davis.
Nominees for Favorite Soul R&B Video by a Male are Philip Bailey with Phil Collins,
the winner is, I think, our favorite Stevie Wonder.
Shut up. I really didn't come here for this reason. But could you all run the video again so I can look at it and see how it looks? Well, thank you very much. Thanks to my family and all of my staff and everybody. I love you, everybody.
Stevie Wonder's jacket. Oh, no, okay. Tonight's show is a great celebration. And this next group should know about celebrations because they wrote the song. They've got plenty to celebrate because since they began in 1969, they've had 16 top 40 records. And since 1980 alone, they've had 5 consecutive gold albums. Wow! Ladies and gentlemen, Kool and the Gang! Video by a male is LaToya Jackson and Weird Al Yankovic.
Hey, you're funny.
Honey, you're on now.
You know, all this time, I still haven't met your brother, Reggie. One of these days.
Oh, maybe one of these days.
The nominees for favorite pop rock video by a male are Phil Collins,
Huey Lewis,
Bruce Springsteen,
and the winner is Bruce Springsteen.
Bruce called me up last night and said, Al, if I don't show up, I want you to have this. Thank you, Bruce, and thank all of you. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
To present the award for favorite pop rock video group, here, Sheila E., David Foster, and Lee Greenwood.
Thank you. The nominees for favorite pop rock video by a group are
The Eurythmics,
Tears for Fears, and the winners are
the winner is Sheila E. Oh, I'm sorry, wrong. The winner is Wham.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Firstly, I'd like to apologize for the fact that my friend Andrew isn't here. I'm not going to lie to you, he missed his plane. Secondly, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the American public for making last year an amazing year for us. Thank you very much.
Favorite country video group. Here is Larry Blackmon and Gary Morris.
The nominees for favorite country video by a group are Alabama,
The Highwaymen,
but I will remain.
The Highwaymen, Willie Nelson, Christopher Stockton, Waylon Jennings, Johnny Cash.
The Oak Ridge Boys.
And the winners are in Tucson, The Highwaymen, Willie Nelson, Chris McCarthy, William James, and Johnny Cash.
Hey, huh? You won.
Won?
Yeah.
Willie?
Won what?
The Country Video of the Year Award.
Who? Willie, Waylon, Chris, and I?
Yeah.
Great. Let's celebrate.
Do the honors.
Woo! Thank you. Thank you.
To present the favorite soul R&B video by a group, here is An Emotions, Astrid Plain, and Bill Wadhams, and James Ingram.
nominees for favorite song on the video by group are Astrid and Simpson. The Pointer Sisters.
And the winner is...
Pointer Nervous.
The Pointer Sisters!
Sisters couldn't be here tonight, so we accept it on their behalf. Have a good year, Pointers.
Last year, I came to the show to pay tribute to some friends who had recently been lost to music. It was Count Basie, it was Marvin Gaye, Ernest Tubbs, and Jackie Wilson. This year, tribute didn't seem necessary until just a few weeks ago, when we lost Ricky Nelson.
A traveling man, made a lot of stops all over the world. But it's all right now. I learned my lesson well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you've got to please yourself.
Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet, starring the entire Nelson family, Ozzie, Harriet, David, and Ricky.
That show ran for 14 years, and in that time, millions of Americans came to consider the Nelsons part of their own family. I did. At the memorial services for Rick, hundreds of friends were especially moved when his twin sons played and sang. Here now are the Nelsons.
Thank you very much. Before we start, I'd like to say hello to my brother Sam, who couldn't be here with us tonight. Rick Nelson loved rock and roll. 30 of his 45 years were spent in the music industry. At the age of 16, his version of Fats Domino's I'm Walkin' sold 1 million copies in 1 week. In 1960, Life magazine created the phrase teen idol to describe him. He was placed number 6 on Billboard's top 40 list of all-time great recording artists. He had 22 gold records. But by far his most important contribution was the fact that Rick Nelson made rock and roll acceptable to millions of people who would have otherwise stayed away. His work was raw, honest, and to the point. He never sold out. He was an artist, and we're very proud of him.
Last year, we did a lot of playing in the LA clubs, and this past year especially held a lot of meaning to us because my dad was on the road all the time. He could never make it to the shows, but this year he got to catch the tail end, and he was really proud of us, as we were of him. And of one of our songs, he liked it very much when we slowed down in the middle of our set and sang this ballad that we're going to sing for you, and we hope you like it as much as he did.
After so many years, so hard to believe, the sight of your face so hard to conceive, an image of you as there never was such. I sing to your soul, to your strength, to your touch, and to our love.
It was there from the start.
Be still, be still, be still.
My selfish heart. Well, it's taken so long just to say what I feel, but it's taken so long just to know it's for real. I hope I'm not giving up so damn fast. I want you so bad and I want it to last. Into your touch, it will take.
still be still. My selfish heart. It was a hero moment in the heart of a dream, igniting my soul and extent still unseen. It cures me all, everywhere have you been? Oh please, oh please, oh please, please just understand me and what this nonsense means. Oh. So hard to conceive, an image of you as I never was such. I sing to your soul, to your strength, to your touch, and to our love. It was there from the start. Be still, be still, be still. My selfish heart. Be still, be still, be still. My selfish heart.
Presenting the award for favorite country male, Fee Waybill and Freddie Jackson.
The nominees for favorite country male are Lee Greenwood, Willie Nelson, and Hank Williams Jr.
And the winner is in Tucson, Willie Nelson.
Well, as you all know, Willie couldn't be here tonight. He's feeling a little under the weather, but on behalf of his headband, I'd like to accept this award. Hey, John! Johnny!
What?
Willie won.
Won what?
The award.
Congratulations, Willie.
All right.
It's time for the Favorite Soul R&B Male Award. Here are REO's Kevin Cronin and Rebe Jackson.
The nominees for Favorite Soul R&B Male are Prince.
Luther Vandross.
And Stevie Wonder.
And the winner is Stevie Wonder.
Thank you very much, Bill Parker, and thank everybody very much. And
now, the award for pop rock male, ladies and gentlemen, Janet Jackson and EXILE.
How you doing? The nominees for favorite pop rock male are
Phil Collins,
Prince,
Bruce Springsteen.
And the winner is Bruce Springsteen.
Bruce couldn't be here tonight, so we know that he's as excited about winning this award as we are accepting it for him. The boss says thanks.
American Music Awards brought to you by McDonald's. It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's. And Bud Light, the light beer with the first name in taste. Everything else is just light.
It's time for tonight's final special awards. The best way to tell the story of these awards is to start near the end. Just a year ago tonight, last year's American Music Awards closed with Lionel Richie being joined on stage by all the stars and singing a special version of Let It Be.
Let it be, 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 let it be.
Right after the American Music Awards last year, a lot of us joined other stars from around the country and hurried over to A&M Studios for an extraordinary event. But before we go any further, let's go back to the beginning.
My heart is down, my head is turning around.
Harry Belafonte is an actor, a producer, and one of our most gifted musical personalities.
Six and seven and eight and five, they like come, I won't go.
I have been on the National Advisory Council.
But as busy as he's been in the entertainment business, he's always found time for civil rights, the Peace Corps, and so many other humanitarian activities.
There's a courage here. There's a strength here that's eternal.
So it wasn't surprising when he approached Ken Cragen with the idea of American musical stars doing something to help millions of people starving in Africa. And Ken responded by bringing Quincy Hello? Jones into the project to help gather a group of top stars for a recording that would raise money for famine relief. But first, a very special song was needed, and Michael Jackson and Lionel Richie agreed to write it. They put in long hours getting just the right message and melody, a song that would appeal to the ears and the hearts of the world. Then on January 28th, we all got together at the studio. There was nothing but good feelings in that room. Old friends said hello, and lots of new friendships were made, and some very special memories. There were laughs when everybody started to sing Harry's Banana Boat song. And there were tears when Stevie Wonder introduced a young woman from Ethiopia.
In English, on behalf of my country, we thank you for all you have done. Thank you very much.
And then the session was over. We all felt good about it, but I don't think we had any idea of what had really happened. It was a song, it was an idea, and it was a prayer that was heard around the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Rome, Georgia, we are part of the world.
In fact, on April 5th, it was played simultaneously on 6,000 radio and television stations, and the world responded.
African Famine Relief Fund.
We are the world. We are the children.
We are the world. We are the children.
We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's start giving.
A better day, just you and me.
And It's time to honor the man whose concern got the USA for Africa project started. The American Music Awards of Appreciation goes to Harry Belafonte.
Thank you very, very much. A few years ago, in the state of New York, a group of artists came together to raise their voices on behalf of some local folk who were in need. That night, a man by the name of Pete Seeger, a man by the name of Donnie McLean, a man by the name of Harry Chapin, and myself, in a cold theater, talked about the plight of the underclass. Harry Chapin said that he had decided that he was going to spend the rest of his life in the gift that he had been given in the service of people who were in need, and that he was going to see to it that perhaps through his efforts, by the end of this century, there would be no more hunger on this globe. Harry Chapin died 5 years ago. It was a cruel death and a great loss. But he had thrown a pebble into a pond, and I saw the ripples. It reached Geldof, it reached me, it reached Willie Nelson, it reached millions of people around the world. I accept this award tonight on behalf of all those pebbles that have fallen to all those ponds everywhere in the world, and all those ripples that have made a difference. I particularly want to acknowledge all the men and women, the thousands of volunteers who are in Africa at this very moment, feeding the hungry, caring for the ill, and perhaps the most significant ripple of them all will be the one that will reach out on the 25th of May in this country, when all hands will come together in a project called Hands Across America to finally wipe out hunger in this country forever. I must also acknowledge the fact that the ripple has gone much further than I think Harry Chapin even realized, because it's with people like Stevie Wonder and others who have also put themselves in the service of stamping out those political systems which cause hunger, like that in South Africa and those forces against apartheid. I think that it's important for everyone to know that art is not only supposed to show life as it is, but it's also supposed to show life as it should be. I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge four people who really made a great difference in this project. Two for moving it forward. One is our leader, Ken Cragen. Quincy Jones, who made us all leave our egos at the door. And the two artists who, without their great gift, would not have inspired us in quite the same way as we were inspired, Mr. Lionel Richie and Mr. Michael Jackson.
In addition, I'd like to thank four wonderful people.
I already did all that.
I know you did. I'll thank them too. oh, as well. I'd like to bring them up. Can we?
Yes.
We'd like to bring up Michael Jackson and Lionel Richie. Is Quincy Jones here and Ken Kerrigan? Are they here? Why don't we try to get all the performers that were there tonight, that night, a year ago, so we can sing We Are the World together? LaToya, the Jacksons, can you come up on the stage? We're the Jeffrey Osborne. All right. Is everybody coming up? Yeah. All right. We are the world. We are the children. Elizabeth, we are the ones to make a brighter day. So let's start giving. Sing along, would you? There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. It's true, we make a better day. Just you and me. Everybody sing with us.
We are the world. We are the children.
From home for the stars. Charlie O'Donnell speaking.
shoot.